we have this lovely kid here, the special boy, weaned, nice weaner, but unfortunately he has a what we call an aural hematoma, pretty much swelling of the ear due to capillary, the microvessels in the ear rupturing, causing blood and other fluid to accumulate. So I'm gonna perform a little mini surgery. I'm gonna tweak the procedure a little bit. Ideally he should be sedated, but he ate some food, but we're gonna navigate that and get him sorted out. So here goes. Completed our aural hematoma repair, scientific terminology. In a sense, we just pretty much tried to correct the accumulation of blood and fluid in the ear. So an aural hematoma, in a sense, in simple explanation, layman explanation, would be the capillaries, the small blood vessels in the ears rupturing. The cause is actually unknown as to why the blood vessel rupture. But it's assumed, it's theorized that it's attributed to possibly shaking of the head or some other cause, but the full cause is not really known. So pretty much, as I said earlier, with nowhere to go, no outlets, no outlet portal, the fluid just accumulates and the swelling increases in size. It's more commonly seen in dogs than goats. But this guy's a special guy, so we decided to work on him today. So we just made an incision on the inner part of his ear. So you still expect some swelling over the next few days post-procedure, but that should decrease with all the drainage and everything and the medication. Right, so we'll be giving him an injectable antibiotics, injection for medication for pain, and also I just gave him something to kind of help him to clot a little so we can expedite the healing process. So he'll be isolated for a while, given food, water, so he can be paid special attention for the next few days, and he should be fine. So within 10 to 14 days he should be good. So we placed some non-absorbable sutures in there, so those will heal over time. So alternatively I could place some sutures that would not be absorbable, but I'd have to return to remove them after 10 days or so. So also during the surgical procedure, you would have noted that he was wide awake and had to be somewhat physically restrained. The decision was taken to go ahead without much anesthesia, just a tiny tad bit of local, just a minute amount, just so we can go through with the procedure. But the reason for not putting him under anesthesia, which is the ideal situation, was because we did not fast him. So we ideally for surgery, goats should be fasted for 20 to 24 hours, no food, no water. And the reason for that is that during surgery, if they're not fasted, they tend, when the body is at relaxed state, in a relaxed state, they tend to what we call aspirate or bring up back their ruminal content. And there is a possibility for that to go into the trachea, into the lungs, and of course you'll have an animal that's drowned on its own food content. So that's the reason for fasting an animal before surgery. Of course your veterinarian would advise you that. So that was the main reason why we did not anesthetize. So just a minute local anesthetics, and with a little help from our capable crews, yeah, he did quite well. He cooperated. So that's it. So our boy here should be fine over the next few days, and hopefully his air will return to as close to normality as possible and be ready for his new home. All right, thanks for watching.
Thank you, sir.
All right.